Hi there, and welcome to this video on how to sell information products online. If at some point you've been asking yourself, is it really worth my while to sell these sort of products? Or how do I go about actually choosing the right product to sell? Or how do I promote these information products? And lastly, how can I make money from selling information products? If you've asked any of these questions, then this video is going to give you the answers to all of them. My name is Rupesh, and I'd like to welcome you to this channel and to this video. It's all about helping you to find the best possible ways to make money. So if it's your first time at this channel, go ahead and click on the subscribe button so that you can be kept up to date on what is happening within the world of online business. And if you're looking to make money from starting your very own online business, then check out my number one recommendation by clicking on the link that is directly below this video. So let's see what I'm going to cover today in this video. Okay, so this is what we're going to cover today. First topic we're going to talk about is why you should choose information or digital products. Then we're going to talk about how to choose the right products. Then we're going to talk about how you go about promoting your products. And finally, how do you actually make money with selling these products? Now, is there a real benefit to choosing to sell information or digital products over your traditional physical products? Take a look. So some of the cool benefits of selling digital products is, first of all, the profit margins are much more higher. If you're selling physical products, then it's called e-commerce, and your profits will be lower compared to selling digital products. People can access these products instantly, so all they have to do after they're getting paid, they will get these products either sent via their email and they can start enjoying the product. And with digital products, you also have the option, which is really cool, of earning low or high ticket commissions. Now, how do you find the right type of product to promote? Well, that all starts from you choosing the type of industry that you want to target. If you find the right industry, then you go into the right niche and then you choose the right product. So let me show you the different types of niches that you can target. So the first step is that you have to decide on the niche or the industry that you want to target. And some of the most common ones are the health, wealth, and the relationship niche. However, there are other niches that you can target as well. For example, the music industry, you can target the animal and pet care industry, as well as the education industry. So here we are in affiliate marketplace area called Digistore. Now, Digistore is a marketplace just like ClickBank, JVZoo, even Amazon for that matter. You can also promote those products. Now, I just want to show you the different type of products within a specific industry. For example, here in the animal and pet industry, they have these sort of products here. Lunging Gores is self-study, owners, Dow Dog, Owner's Delight, and training techniques. So these are all ebooks that you can sell. And I said you have the education industry as well. And this is where the Digistore 24 Academy membership sites. These master classes they also have. TikTok Mastery for Businesses, YouTube Manifestation. So these are all online education courses that you can promote. And then you also have in the dating love relationship niche, and this one here is the Secret Obsession, Insane Conversions, Make Him Worship You, and so forth. And you see each of these products, they will have a breakdown of how popular the products are, and once you click on promote, then you can get the affiliate link and you can promote them. They also have a sales page which you can check out for a particular product. And one of the common niche areas are, of course, internet marketing and e-business. And here is Tube Mastery and Monetization. I suggest you advance keyword tool, Tube Monetization Automation Program, and so forth. Apart from the affiliate marketplaces, you can also do a normal regular Google search to find any products that you want to promote. And here's a quick tip for you. Say you want to target the dating industry, for instance. You just type in dating plus and then put in the word affiliate program, and you'll see a bunch of affiliate programs coming up, and you're more than welcome to join any or sign up to any of those affiliate programs and promote those specific products. But what I want to say at this point is that when you're choosing a product, it's very important to get yourself familiar with the product. Instead of just having an affiliate link and just promoting it, make yourself acquainted with what the product's all about. If necessary, buy the product or do intensive research, or maybe even ask the vendor if they can send you a review copy of the affiliate product. And this is important because at the end of the day, it's your online reputation that is at stake. And you wouldn't promote a product that you yourself wouldn't buy, right? So do your intense research on the product before you go ahead and promote it. Now, how do you promote your products? Let's take a look. Of course, promoting a product means that you're going to need to get eyeballs to your website or to your business. And that would mean that you need to choose a specific traffic method. You can go for blogging, or search engine optimization. So what it simply means is you write a specific blog article, and once that blog article gets ranked onto Google and various other search engines, you'll get visitors to that article, and they will in turn purchase what it is that you are reviewing or talking about. Then the other option is to go for YouTube. Now, YouTube is the second largest search engine after Google, and obviously there you can promote your product by doing product reviews. You can also then go to other social media like Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Pinterest, and LinkedIn. And then you can go on some paid traffic methods such as pay-per-click advertising. And this is where you pay for every click that the users or your audience click on in order to see what product you are promoting. And then you can also do email marketing, and this is where you regularly write or you have an autoresponder in place, which I'm going to show you how that actually works in the next step to get your customers more engaged and getting them to see what it is that you have to offer. Eventually, they will buy for you. Okay, so now, thus far, you know of some of the benefits to selling digital products. You also know how to go about selecting the right products. And you now also know that if you're going to sell products, you're going to have to be engaged in some sort of traffic method in order to get eyeballs to see your offer. But how do you make that all-important sale? And how do you get conversions? And this is what I'm going to show you next, that it's not just about you getting that affiliate link and pasting it on social media platforms, because first of all, social media platforms are not going to like it. They're going to see it as spam. And secondly, people won't just buy it. You might get one or two sales, but if you're selling a product that's maybe a bit more high ticket, then you need to do a bit more work. And this method I'm going to show you is extremely effective in getting that all important sale. Check it out. Okay, so now this is a sales funnel. So this is normally what you would use to effectively sell affiliate products. And this is a process that most of your visitors would go through in order for you to not only get the details, but to build a relationship with them for them to eventually buy from you. So the first part of the sales funnel is a capture page. And this is where they would put in their email address. You can even ask them for their name if you want to, but a simple one would be just to put in their email address, and this would normally go to a lead magnet. So in exchange for the email address, it might be an ebook or a course or something that you're giving them in exchange. And once you've got the email address on your database, that goes into your autoresponder. The autoresponder is simply an email software that stores everybody's email address once they opt in here. And what happens is, it's very important here, because in your autoresponder, you're going to build an automation. Automation means it's just a series of emails. And this series of emails is the emails that you'll be sending to your customer on a regular basis. And it will have to be due on any specific information that's related to the initial problem that they had. And you're going to give them valuable and helpful advice or information. And the main idea, I'm going to tell you that towards the end of this video, but once that takes place, then the customer can be sent also to your bridge page. But now your bridge page is just a page, and this is where you would tell them more about yourself. And from this bridge page, you can send them to the actual sales page of your product. But now I want to tell you why this automation here is so important. So the prospect now opted into your offer and they went to your bridge page. In the bridge page, they learned about how the product itself has made a difference in your life, but they're still not convinced. And even if they go to the sales page, they might not purchase the product. But this is not the end of the world for you, because remember, you have their email in your autoresponder database. And this is good news, because what it means now is you have the opportunity of having an automation or an email series built that's going to provide value to this customer over a series of time. Maybe it can be a couple of days or weeks or months or whatever, but it's going to be based around providing them value on the topic that they initially needed some help with. And the main point of this is to establish a relationship with your prospect. Eventually, they're going to get to know you. You're going to get credibility with them. They're going to get your trust, and you're going to establish authority with them. And eventually, they will buy from you whatever it is that you are promoting. So that now covers the entire process on how to go about from finding your informational products, how to go about looking for the specific traffic sources, and how to promote your information products. I hope that this video on how to go about selling your own information products has helped you out. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them directly below this video and I will get back to you. But if you would like to learn on how you can get started with your very own profitable online business, then click on the link that is below this video and you can see for yourself on how you can get started within the world of online business. Thanks so much for watching, and I'd like to take this opportunity to wish you everything of the best in your online success. See you.